Hello friends, today we will discuss about clearing the foul anchor. So what is foul anchor? Foul cable. Foul cable means when the vessel is anchored using two anchors, and when the ship turns 180 degree or 360 degree heading, and both the cables will get entangled like this, and this condition is called foul. Among these two cables, starboard side cable and port side cable, one of the cable will not be having any weight, and the other one will be having a weight on it. So the cable which is having weight, and it will be looks like a straight cable because it is having lots of weight. So that straight cable is called a riding cable. And the cable which is having no weight is called sleeping cable. So normally in anchor situation, foul cable situation, the foul you will not be able to see unless and until you pick up the anchor chain. So it will be mostly underwater. So then to clear this foul, you need certain materials like natural fiber rope, preventer wire, messenger wire, and temporary easing wire. And this preventer wire, messenger wire, you can use wire ropes which is having enough SWL to withstand the weight of the chain. And when you are doing this operation, you have a 6 hour window. Why this 6 hour window is? Whenever the tide changes, this ship's heading will change again, and so you have to prepare all the equipments well in advance, and you have to arrange everything properly, and there are lots of lashing to be taken along with this chain and with all these ropes. And as soon as the tide changes and the ship settles down, then you start doing the operation. Okay. So once you start doing the operation, then you have a next 6 hours to finish this task. So if you are not able to finish within 6 hours, the ship will change again, and that will be an unfavorable condition for you. Okay. So I will discuss about the steps to be followed. The first step to be, initially this is underwater, so first step to be, you pick up the riding cable. You pick up the riding cable, so slowly the foul will come above the water level. So that is the first step you have to do. So I'll show with little bigger diagram. So after the first step, after you pick up the foul above the water level, it will looks like this. This is the starboard side anchor chain going straight below to the water level, and this is the port side cable which is entangled with the starboard side anchor cable. So now the second step. So let's say first step, pick up riding cable. Okay. The second step is foul above the water level. That is also you did. Water level. And the third step, that is lash a natural fiber rope above the foul. So this is the foul, and you have to lash a natural fiber rope above the foul. So I am drawing a natural fiber rope lashed. So let's assume this is the place where you lash the natural fiber rope above the foul. So this rope will be coming from the fair lead, whichever side the foul cable is there. So this is a natural fiber rope. This has to be lashed above the foul, because the foul is here and you are lashing it above the foul. okay, natural fiber rope above to be lashed. Okay, and the fourth one is temporary easing wire. The fourth one is rig a preventer wire through the sleeping cable after lashing. So this is the sleeping cable, okay, and you have to rig a preventer wire through this sleeping cable after the foul. So this is above the foul, this position is above the foul, this position is below the foul. So you have to rig a preventer wire. So you can use the preventer wire from this side. Okay, so one preventer wire will come like this, that will go like this, and it again go back to the ship's forward deck through the same fairlead which came out, and it will go out, go in again. Okay, this preventer wire will be secured in ship's bollard with the figure of eight. One end will be secured with the figure of eight because it has to take the weight of this fouled cable, and another end also you can secure it with the bollard in a figure of eight manner. Okay, when we are at the final stage, you have to let go this figure of eight. So that time you have to use a chain stopper here and remove the weight, and you should let go using a slip arrangement method. Okay, that we will discuss later. And the fourth step is, that is what we discussed. Okay, rig a wire preventer. And through sleeping cable below the fowl. Okay, that is what this. Okay, so we will name it preventer wire. Okay, this is number four. Okay, now this is natural wire, natural fiber rope. Okay, this is step number three. Okay, now the fifth step. Now the fifth step is heave the preventer wire and have it lashed on the mooring bit. Okay, so the wire which is passed around the sleeping cable will go back to the deck again. You have to heave it using a ship's mooring warping drum and lash it with the ship bollard. That is the fifth step. Heave preventer wire and lash it. Okay. Now the sixth step. Walk back sleeping cable until next joining shackle on deck. Okay, so this is our main deck, and we have the windlass here. This cable is coming through the windlass, and you have to walk back, means you have to lower this sleeping cable So what will happen when you lower the sleeping cable? The cable will come like this. A little bit of weight will come in. Sorry, not weight. The cable will come down. The cable will come down. So till you have to lower it till. You have to lower it till the next joining shackle. Okay. So you know what is joining shackle? Joining shackle is a bigger shackle which is joining each 27.5 meters of the chain. Okay. You have to walk back the gypsy till the next joining shackle will come on deck. Okay. That is the sixth step. Walk back, sleep cable till next joining shackle is on deck. Okay, so this is joining shackle. Okay, this is point number six. And the seventh step, rig ease wire on the shackle forward of the joining shackle. That means this is joining shackle, right? And these are the small links. Okay, so you have to rig a easing wire. Okay, so that you have to rig an easing wire which is forward of the joining shackle. So one easing wire will come and you will lash the easing wire forward of this joining shackle, and you will secure this easing wire on a strong point, bollard or something like that, with the figure of eight method. Okay, that's how you do it. Now what is this this step is this is easing wire. This is point number seven. Now the point number eight. So after rigging this wire, you can lower this chain little bit further. Okay, and so the easing wire will take the weight of the sleeping cable which is till this position. So you can lower further, and this joining shackle, right, you have to disconnect this joining shackle. So this joining shackle is called kender shackle. Okay, so the ninth step is disconnect the joining seventh step is that one, rig the easing wire. Okay, that I have not written. Seventh step is rig easing wire forward of joining shackle. Okay, so that is what we did. Is this is seven, this is here. And the eighth step is disconnect the joining shackle. It is disconnect joining shackle. Joining shackle, this one is eight. So after disconnecting, it will look like this. So this is our joining shackle. You will disconnect the chain using this. You will disconnect this joining shackle. So the sleeping cable of this side is already lashed with the easing wire. So that is already secured. The bollard. Okay. So that is this point number seven and point number 8. After doing this point number 7 and point number 8, this will look like this. Okay. Now one important thing. So after step number 8, this is how it looks like. The joining shackle will be removed. The other end of the sleeping cable is tied with an easing wire. And if you look from the bow, this is the sleeping cable which is tied with an easing wire. The normal joining shackle is just remaining in the gypsy. Now you can disengage the windlass gypsy. Now you have to pass a messenger wire rope. Okay, you have to pass a messenger wire rope, and that will be passing through the fairlead. Okay, that messenger wire rope will pass through the fairlead first. Okay, that messenger rope will come out of the fairlead. Okay. Now you remember the which way, what is the direction of the foul. The sleeping cable is fouled like this, coming like this. It is going below the green cable and twisting and coming up the and again going through the other side like this and like this. Okay. So this messenger wire, this messenger wire has to retrace the direction of the foul. Okay, so it will come like this and it will go like this and it will pass below the green cable and again go back to the main deck through the sperling pipe. So the direction will come like this, come like this, come like this, it will come like this, come like this, come like this. So at the end this messenger rope and comes and connect with the one of the shackle of the sleeping cable. So the messenger wire will go through the sperling pipe like this. It will take a proper direction like this and it will come back and it will be connected to the one end. So at this point the easing wire is also connected, the messenger wire is also connected. Okay, this is step number 9. So this direction is very important. I will tell you why it is very important. Okay. So now the step number 10 is, what we are going to do is, this preventer wire, you see this preventer wire, we keep this preventer wire very tight. Okay. And what we are going to do is, this messenger wire, the beginning, where the first end of the messenger wire will be connected to the warping drum. Okay, this is a warping drum. This one will go to the warping drum and make sufficient end like this. Okay, other end is like this. So what the warping drum will do, it will start pulling in this direction. Start pulling the wire which is come this way. So what will happen? Messenger wire will try to go back in the same direction which is through which it came back. It came. So what will happen when the messenger wire is pulled back? This sleeping cable will also go back along the direction the messenger wire is there. So we have arranged messenger wire in a direction so that when we pull pull back, it will bring the messenger, the sleeping cable, in the same direction, so that it will clear the half turn of the foul. Okay, so when we are pulling, this easing wire has to be lowered slowly. So when the easing wire will be lowered, so the messenger wire will be pulled. That messenger wire will guide the sleeping cable, and the sleeping cable will slowly come in this direction, in this direction, along the same way the messenger wire, and it will come below the riding cable, and it will exit, and it will again go back to the hose pipe once again. So by doing this, what will happen? At finally, after doing this procedure, this much turn of the sleeping cable will be removed, and the sleeping cable will now looks like this. Okay, now only have one turn. So this method is again repeated to remove if you have another turn. So this is the way you will remove the foul of the cable. Okay, I hope you understood. Okay, you try watch this video and try to make a note by yourself repeatedly. Okay, thank you.